Okay, so it's lockdown. I don't know which day it is. I've lost count. I'm absolutely loving it, to be honest. I'm loving the peace and quiet and time to create in the kitchen, in the garden, and on canvas, and obviously drawing too. So today I want to share with you a bit of portrait painting, but portraits of my Daisy. Yeah, I decided that would be a bit more fun. Principles apply, same as portraiture, but just sort of a bit more fun. So let me get a picture of her. I couldn't print one out, so let me try and get one up for you on the screen. That's my Daisy. So it's not a very good pick there. I couldn't print a color one, so I'm going to use this and lead you step by step along the way on how to paint a portrait. And just light-hearted, having fun, nothing too serious. Right, let's start. So, first of all, have a look at your canvas. You're probably restricted by what you've got during this lockdown stage. So you can even use board, paper, masonite board, old paintings, anything that you've got. Fabric, even paint with some wall and all, and stretch it onto board, or whatever you want. I'm going to very quickly talk you through the plotting gridding process. So what you do, number one, and I will send you notes to anyone who's interested, you can ask me for the notes for plotting. But what I do is I measure the length of the canvas. It's 405 by 305. So I divide 405 divided by 305 gives me 1.327. I just rounded off to 1.33. So my x is 1.33. Now what I do is I look at my reference and I decide, right, on the composition, have a look at the composition. It's pretty standard now. It's pretty much like the canvas. What I'm going to do is I'm going to choose the length. Don't worry about the width at this stage. The length is 26 centimeters. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go length divided by my x will equal my width. My length is 26 divided by my x factor, which was 1.33, equals, let's do that's what happens when you don't know how to use your cell phone. Right, so my width has to equal 19.55. So that's how you do it. My notes are quite clear, so it'll be easier to get them from that. But what basically I'm doing is I'm making sure that the proportions of length to width are the same as my length to width on my canvas. Mine was slightly different. I had to bring the reference in ever so slightly in the photo. I had to bring the width in a little bit. So I'm really happy with that composition. I think it's really, really going to work for me. So then the idea is when you've got the format, it's exactly the same proportionately as your canvas, then you just divide the reference into halves and then into quarters. Then you can have a look at it and see where there's the most activity, which is usually where the eyes and the mouth and the nose are, and you can just divide those squares up again. Then what you need to do is you need to halve and quarter the canvas. It's just halve and quartering. But before I do that, I'm going to activate my canvas. I'm going to splash on some warm ink. Actually decide I'm going to choose a dialer orange because I think it'll give it a nice new fresh glow. Now, one of the reasons why I activate is because it creates warmth and unity in a painting. For example, white is the coldest color on the all colors. So by adding a warm orange, it immediately gives it a glow and a second layer to my painting before I've even begun. It also takes away the whiteness, takes away the preciousness of the canvas. It makes beautiful incidental marks that I love. So I'm going to stop for now and I'm going to splash on some ink. I'm not going to demo that because it's very simple, and then we'll take it from there. Right, so excuse the shaky hand. I'm having to hold my iPad while I show you. I'm using a disposable palette. I've chosen three colors, a blue, a red, and yellow. I always do this, especially for teaching and particularly beginners. In this case, I went quite intuitively and I've chosen a Prussian blue, a cad red light hue, a cad yellow pale hue, and titanium white. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do a bit of a color swatch to see if these colors will make up the sort of the atmosphere that I'm wanting to create in my portrait of my little Daisy. Let's have a look and see. So I'm going to put the iPad down, mix up some colors, and then I can show you if I think this is going to work or not. Right, just showing you a couple of portraits I've done of animals, the ones that I've got in my home to show you. Now what I'm really wanting to point out from this is that I'm looking at shapes and planes and tonal value, building up my painting in that way, not worrying about elephants and trunks and feet and so on. By looking at shapes and tonal values, actually more important than color, you build up a painting and I think the main thing is not to get fixated with trying to draw a horse or a dog or a cat. Just enjoy the abstract forms and bring them all together to create an atmosphere. Right, so I'm going to show you the colors that I've chosen. Right, so here you have my color, my palette, Prussian blue, the top left hand corner, cad red light, cad yellow pale, and then white down here. And I mixed up some darks, the coolest dark, slightly warmer, warmer still, and warmest. So I've mixed up four, always looking at color in terms of temperature. The cooler one has got more blue in it. This one has got a little bit more red, less blue, more red, a little bit of yellow, tiny bit of blue. So I did a little color swatch of these. You can see the cooler one is there, the cooler dark, the warmer. Can you see that this isn't warm? This one isn't warm, but in comparative to this one, it is warmer. So you can see it's got a slightly more red hue. The lighting isn't perfect here for video, but I'm giving it a bash. Then you've got the slightly warmer one. So it goes from there to there. Quite a big bounce. There could be a color in between. But there we go, warmer and warmest. So I'm thinking that these color combinations will make a great painting of our Daisy. There's some lovely grays coming in there, and I think it's going to really, really work. There are my paints, there are my mediums, my glasses, my refreshments. See, I use a size 3 palette, or there we are, that'll help you. It's not necessarily size 3, it does depend on what make palette knife you use. Right, so let's begin. But first I'm going to grid my canvas, which I'll do in a couple of minutes, and then we'll get going. Right, so now that my canvas has been gridded, you can see that I've gone halves, quarters, and then I've just done an extra grid in these two squares because that's where the eyes are. So keeping it very, very simple. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my coolest dark, and I'm going to really thin it up with linseed oil and terps, and I'm going to just start drawing in these shapes. I'm not looking at ears right now. I'm just looking at shapes, looking at positives and negatives, and not stressing too much about detail at all. Just, I'm just letting hold your brush further back. Stand back. Get comfy. Keep your back nice and straight so you don't hurt it. And I'm looking, I'm actually squinting my eyes and I'm looking at just the dark. So I'm looking at the tonal values. The darkest darks. Slide down there. So you're a good foundation for any style of painting. Really, you can also have your own style. Absolutely. Doesn't have to be my style, haphazard style of my work. It can be your own, but it just helps you. It's a simple process. Thin paint, got too much paint on my brush there. See how I'm doing it carefully, and to be as cautious as I'm being right now. Bit more oil and turps in my brush. Yeah, my direction, my brush strokes is going in the direction that the fur would be. And if I was doing a face, the brush strokes would be going in the direction of the planes of the face. Be careful not to hum to the music. Remember, I'm not alone. Doing is I'm looking at the positives and negatives. That shape is the positive and this is the negative. Actually, you can see it in any way you wish. Whoops. There we go. Time for a rag. Here's my rag. Always have a rag on hand. Paint with a rag. Carry on looking at shapes. See, this whole dark area here is a shape. I'm not looking at it in terms of legs, fluff, chest of a dog. I'm just looking at it in terms of shape. Negative here.